Hi there, welcome to Scrap and Coffee. I'm here with a final share of the breakfast that I've made for the tutorial. So it's finished. I just finished filming the tutorial for the handle, and the second breakfast is done, and I want to show you what I did with the matting. Again, I used the Flutter and Bloom paper collection by Paper Phenomenon. So that was the second project that I made with the collection, and again it turned out awesome, so beautiful. So yeah, let me show you. Of course, we made that handle out of Tyvek again. We're using eyelets, breads, and jump rings. On the cover, I've got one of the strips out of the collection to size, and mounted that on black cardstock and place some breads on there for decorations, and it said spread your wings. On the front and on the back, I've used the same paper with the beautiful flowers and some script. And on the front, I just made a cut in here. And Cathy King has a really nice name for it, but it doesn't come to mind for now. And I've placed some photo mats in there, so you can place a photo in here, just one, or maybe a little card that you for the one that receives it, if you're making it as a gift. And that just adds a little bit of extras on that cover, I think. So we used magnets for the closure, and the magnets, I've let them sink into the chipboard, so I don't have... you can feel them, but it's not like they're lying on top of the chipboard, so that's also a really nice feature. You can do that for all your projects if you want. Now when we open it up, we have to turn it around. And then this is what we get. So here I've made the waterfall with the slide-in closure. So this is magnetized. I can open it up and slide it in here. Now as you can see, I've placed a butterfly on here. So you can do it, but that does limit you on how far you can slide it in. But this is far enough for me. So here I made the waterfall with the acetate only on one side. So this is a normal flap, so I can place the magnet on there. And here you can place your photos. Room for 3x4 photos. Your frame is a little over 2x3. So like I said in the tutorial, you can place a 4x3 in there. That's what in here right now. And it can be a little bit of a struggle to get it in there, but... So this is a 4x3, so you're not able to see the whole photo, or you can place a 2x3 with a little white frame around it. Of course you can also cut something down to size, but so I've just placed photo mats on the back. This is a removable tape, so it's not really attached a lot, but so you can remove it and replace it for a photo. So this is also the bulk that you will have when your photos are in here. And I just keep this really plain. Just use two different papers for the whole waterfall. And here I've placed again some photo mats. I've used my die cut machine to make some tags. So yeah, there are different options on what you can place in there. And then this goes out. So I've counted that you will be able to place about 25, if you stretch it, to 30 photos, smaller photos in here. So here we have the belly band, kept it a little plain this time, with our two booklets. Again, I did the same thing. This is one image, so they fit underneath each other. And from the same pattern paper, I decorated the back of the booklet. And in the inside, I didn't do anything, so you can place your photo in there. I didn't place any white in here. So one 3x3 and one 3x4 photo you can place in there. Then we have a pocket here that's also a flap. And in the pocket, again, I placed a little tag that I had laying around. And a 3x3 photo. And the same thing over here. So I'm not taking it out completely, but... that's what in there. And then you can open this, and because of the waterfall and the bulk of the waterfall, it won't lay completely flat, but that's okay with me. Here I place a 3x3 cut apart out of the collection, grow through what you go through, and on the other ones, room for your photos. Again, 3x3 and a 3x4 flip it over, and again I made one flap for a photo, and one I placed on patterned paper, because I just love these images going together. So here there was a lot going on, and here it was more, yeah, not so much. So I just figured place it on the bottom, and then your eye will be going towards the bottom as well. And here we have our two separate pockets that can hold photos. I think a 4x4 will fit in here, but you have to crop it down just a little bit. And then also this is a 3x4, but because of the construction of the pocket, it can be a little bit difficult to place it in there, but it will fit, as you can see. And I did the same thing here. So let me take it out so you can see the matting of this side. So really beautiful paper. It's an awesome collection. And I think I heard her say that it was sold out. But I also thought that I saw it on scrapbook.com the other day, that they still have it. But I don't know how much they have. So if you want to get the collection, you can look over there. And also you can get the digital collection from her, from Katie King's shop at Paper Phenomenon, if you want it. And like these smaller projects would be perfect for digital collections. They really would. So that's it. That's the project. So if you haven't seen the first one and you haven't followed the tutorial, then I will give you the measurements. It's 8.5 by 5. With a spine on the bottom that's 1 inch, or a little after construction it's a little bit over 1 inch, and the top spine is 5/8 of an inch, and after construction it's closer to 3/4 of an inch. So I'm really happy with how it turned out. I hope you enjoy it as well. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next project. Enjoy the rest of your day.